When I made the video about the VIP rescue of Central Florida, I had a feeling that there was going to have to be a follow-up video on it. And, well, yeah, it does look like there's going to be a follow-up video on this one. So here it is. I did a little bit of researching, and it turns out that the owner of this company or organization is Pam Pearson. I don't know if she's the one personally who's responding to Facebook comments. If it is, she's not very professional whatsoever, and I can guarantee you that. From what I've researched, she's been in rescue since 2000, so for 17 years. I don't know if this is how she's always done business, but we have a bit to go into today. First, I need to make a correction from the previous video, which was brought to my attention. VIP is the one chipping the dogs. The dogs are coming in unchipped. So there was no chip already in it. They are the one actually chipping the dogs. There was also a complaint brought to me about the photos and the use of the photos. Based on that comment that they're stealing the photos from the finders. However, I asked them if they could elaborate on it, and I never got an answer in time before I made this video. If they do respond, I can always, in the next follow-up, I will add more information to that as it comes to me. Because I want the information on this whole situation to be as legitimate as possible. So let's move on to the biggest thing right now. People that are complaining about them and threatening to go to PetSmart are being threatened by VIP themselves. They're saying that they're going to sue you for damages and go to the IRS. Well, let's touch up on that latter part a little bit later, okay? The first part about the threatening to go for damages, there's not much they can do because it's all publicly available knowledge and no one has actually said anything that isn't actually fact. The reason for that is their responses never have actually addressed the fact that dogs are being sold the day they're being brought in or just within a couple days. That's the complaint. They're not addressing that whatsoever. They say you can come on in and see the paperwork yourself. Here's the problem. How they're responding is absolutely disgusting and impersonally attacking people. Who would want to walk into your store to even see that then? And it's not like information that you can't just say on Facebook. It's not private information. But here's the thing. People that found the dogs are posting that they're found and that they're going to be brought in to be checked. They're saying that they can foster the dog, but then they're flipping and selling it. Now, that's also publicly available information because we can look on the Lost and Found pages and see the paper trail, basically. So what are we walking in for? I already told them I would be happy to interview them, but after what the responses you'll see to me after they saw that I made the previous video, I'm not wasting the gas to drive out over there because it's going to end up being a waste of gas, I can guarantee it. Let's take a look at those responses first. Before I show that, the reason why people are threatening to go to PetSmart is because VIP has a thing with PetSmart that they can host dog adoptions there at PetSmart. And people don't want PetSmart to be associated with that because generally PetSmart does not want to be associated with dog flippers or pet flippers because it's illegal, one, and it's a very immoral thing to do. So that's why people are threatening to go to PetSmart, okay? Okay. Moving along, though, to the responses that we're getting. Let me pull one up here real quick. I'm not going to edit this one. This is just a straight, unedited video. So you'll get to see these in real time. Anyway, take a look. Bring it on, boy. You may be liable for damages. IRS and writing a store without facts. No wonder you have a face for radio. Thank you. I do have a face for radio. An unshaven face, but I do have a beautiful face for radio. The insults don't work for me. I'm sorry. I laugh at these kind of things. not much I can say to that. I mean, did you think I was going to be offended by this? One, that's not professional customer service. And two, you need a PR department because clearly that you don't. This, like I said, I don't know if this is Pam Pearson herself or if someone else runs the Facebook page. But as the official voice of VIP Rescue of Central Florida, I have to think you are Pam Pearson. And we'll get to that, all right? I have something I want to read to you that was posted in one of the Lost and Founds about Pam and her past. We're going to get to that. If there's something about damages that could be non-fact, it would be that. And I'm going to have a disclaimer when I read that one to you because I can't verify that. I can only verify this, but come to your own conclusions on that one. Second response, and you're going to love this one. Because now I'm thinking maybe she's drinking because this response is not proper English. Read it. You will be issued a cease and discuss order by the state of Florida. Check your facts, cowboy. Alleged sunbiz. These are legit. You can go to her Facebook page and look at these comments. They're there. This is all under the comments for the dog Brooke, by the way, if you want to look that up. Brooke being one of the dogs that were in the previous video that was used as an example. It's all under that comment section. I can't keep a straight face when I read these things because all of her comments are like this. It's all the same. So I'm not going to be issued a cease and desist order because this would have to go to court for that to happen. There are no court records about this. In fact, she knows she can't go to court because of the next bullet points I'm about to bring up. Because it would immediately shut down her business. These are facts. And like I said, what I have said that if I have not said that it's not a proven fact, then this is a fact. If I say that it is an opinion or is alleged, then it's that. It's not fact. You have to draw your own conclusions from that. I'm not going to give you any conclusions. I'm only saying my opinion. Hey, look, it's a disclaimer. Ha ha ha. Disclaimers. Good luck with that one now. But yeah, alleged sunbiz. No idea what that means. You must be on mobile and so frantically typing on your keyboard, you're not even looking at what you wrote. Because that makes no sense whatsoever. Okay, so I was going to mention about the IRS thing, and here it is. She is threatening... And I'm saying she because it may be Pam Pearson actually making these comments. She was threatening to involve the IRS for some reason. And I'm not too certain what the IRS would do against us. The IRS has nothing to do with people making comments about your business, okay? Here's where... That could turn on her very badly. If you do a search for under the state of Florida, what businesses are registered to actually solicit for donations, they're not. So for a nonprofit organization to not actually be registered to solicit donations, who do you think the IRS is going to actually be interested in talking to? Not us, you, VIP. They would be more interested in talking to VIP than us because how are you soliciting donations if you're not actually registered to do such a thing and you're a nonprofit and being accused of flipping dogs? You would be crazy to go to a court because anyone you bring to court can easily countersue you, involve the IRS, and holy boy, would your butt need to be puckered for that one. I'm not lying. Because... Already as it is, she's already violated some Florida laws regarding that you have to wait. There's a mandatory waiting period when you find a pet, so that way you can find the suitable owner. 2 days or even same day is not the wait time. And every other rescuer knows, any legitimate rescuer knows about this wait time. It's mandatory. It's not optional. Because you're essentially selling stolen property at that point. That dog clearly belongs to someone, And there's, and if you're not even attempting to look for the owner, which I've checked all the lost and found groups that were pertaining in this general area where these dogs are found or where even VIP is, no, they're not actually making any attempt at all. Once again, look it up yourself if you really want to. You can look in these groups. They're not looking for the owners. All these dogs that are supposedly found are never even being brought up by VIP, except the only people that have actually... the only reason we found about this is because the finders posted about it themselves. And then they went and flipped and turned and want to sell the dogs for like $375. Like same, even say, like as early as same day. Doesn't work that way. You didn't wait ample time. There's a mandatory wait time. I honestly don't know what it is, but I think it's like 20 days or something like that. I could be wrong. Anyone in the comments, correct me on this. Yeah, there's no way you could have possibly have waited. I don't see it happening. One of the other things that I wanted to bring up, though, and this is where my big disclaimer is going to come into play. I don't know if this is true or not, and I'm not even going to mention the names. If you want to know who said it, you can look it up yourself on the Lost and Found pages on Facebook, which is where I've been researching this. I'm going to read it as it as it actually is written in the message. I'm not going to change it. So like I said, you can find it, but draw your own conclusion from it, because I personally cannot verify this one myself. This is what it said. Her name is Pam. It's been a few years. She takes these dogs, saying that she'll foster them, then takes them to the vet, gets them fixed for next to nothing, and sells them for several hundred. I hate this rescue. She would tell us these stories. I was a vet tech at a hospital she took them to. They've had so many complaints. They're no better than the puppy mills that they complain about. Now, there was a story I wanted to talk about because this is a concern, because VIP has done this in 2015. And yes, the real owners of the dog were found, came up to the plate to try to get their dog back, and they did not succeed. It was in 2015. I'm going to see if I can find the Facebook page and maybe pull it up to show. I don't know if I can find it, though, right now. I'm going to try, though. Because, like I said, this has actually happened in 2015. It's not new. Let's see. Like I said, real time, I'm not editing this. I actually don't have the time to do it today. I have some hospital bills that were actually paid, and I have somehow they lost the payment, and I got a lot to deal with, so this is just something I'm doing pretty quick. All right, let's see here. Hide sidebar. I don't need the chat sidebar open. God dang. Everything about Facebook is like, hey, here's your names plastered all over the place, and I'm trying to do this so that way I can actually show it here. All right, here it is. This was made 2 years ago because this dog was taken by VIP, and they would not let the owners even see their dog. They actually denied their rights to see their dog, and then went and flipped the dog, sold the dog for money. That's immediately disgusting, because remember when I said something about there could be like a little girl missing her dog, and it'd be very sad to find out that the dog was sold for profit, and that could ruin a family. I said that when I said that, I did not know this actually happened. This dog was loved by this family, and VIP took the dog and sold the dog to someone else. This owner does not know where the dog is, from what I understand, and VIP won't tell them. That's wrong. That is theft, and you sold stolen property. VIP should be punished for this. It's horrible. And little did I know when I, like when I said, little did I know when I said that, that actually happened. No, no. Pam, if you're even watching this video, you need to reconsider what you're doing. Because personally attacking me for my beautiful radio face is not going to win you any brownie points. In fact, that's going to anger people. And as a business, you can get shut down for that. Now, sure, you're not going to be shut down for insulting someone. But you can be shut down for the counterattack because you're not even registered to solicit donations. You're doing illegal things. Like I said, in Florida, you have to wait a mandatory waiting period, and you're not. So those threats of bringing people to court for damages, you really got to be careful what you're doing. So Pam, like I said, if you're watching this, do the right thing. Look for the owners of these dogs if you actually care about their well-being. Now, her response, like I want, I got to do these disclaimers now. Like I said, if it is her saying these things on Facebook, she said she wants us to step up to the plate and volunteer to work with these dogs. And she says, adopt. All of you ain't adopting this and that. My dog Harley is an adopted dog. I did step up to that plate. I adopted a rescue. One that was taken out of a harmful home by the police department. This is a legitimate rescue. Harley is my baby. And in fact, it's our baby. This whole family loves that dog. But no one, when you're attacking them like that, is going to go to your business and volunteer for you. Especially when you're doing something illegal. They will not be associated with that. Because if you get shut down by the law, they can be just as much in trouble as you are. And they're not going to do that. They're not stupid. With that, her comment, bring it on. Because I was actually one of the people that said that I am going to write to... I was one of the people that said that I am going to write to PetSmart because PetSmart should actually do their own investigation, basically, into this mess. Because that's what's going to happen. PetSmart has to do an investigation. They can't just go on people's word. And that's what she's worried about, obviously, at this point is when she says, bring it on, you'll be liable for damages. She is basically trying to scare you. She doesn't want you to... bring this up to PetSmart in hopes that PetSmart doesn't even look at their own Facebook page to come to their own conclusions. The fact is PetSmart isn't going to just blindly distance themselves from you. They're going to do their own investigation, and then they'll disconnect from you if they find that what everyone is saying is true. So in order to say I'll be liable for, or anyone will be liable for damages, proves you know you're doing wrong and you are guilty. You just are trying to scare them away from even bringing it to their attention to get an investigation, because you probably know if an investigation happens, you're in deep shit. So in response to that, Pam and VIP, in response to that, I sent my letter. I linked to the discussions all about this to my own video. Not this one, obviously, because that was already done. But I might actually update that. But I linked, gave them the pictures to show them proof. All documented everything, screenshotted. Pam, you bring it on. Because everything I posted is legitimately true based on publicly available information. Nothing is made up. We're not going into hearsay or lies. We're going into what is publicly available. Time and date stamped, mind you. And the fact of your current lack of registration. Your move. There will be another follow-up to this video. I never actually... I kind of knew when I made the first one I was going to have to do a follow-up video, and it turns out that I did. So, guaranteed there is going to be a third part of this. As of today, VIP has not made one whisper on Facebook. Not one. Might be the best thing they've done so far is just to shut up. If she did consult a lawyer, that lawyer probably told her to shut up. Quit saying these things on Facebook. You're ruining yourself. Because while everyone thinks that a lawyer is just going to be on your side, a lawyer is, you know, if you're so much in the wrong, the lawyer's going to tell you to stop what you're doing. And that's, if she did consult the lawyer, then that's probably what happened. Because she hasn't said anything yet. Or she's just too stressed and doesn't want to deal with it. We don't know. Like I said, disclaimer, I don't know. And another thing I don't really know about, and but it has been mentioned, but you'll have to draw your own conclusions on this because there is no current facts about it. It's basically just something basically that we think it is. I personally have no opinion on it. But those weird responses, like 3i, well, someone else spotted someone else doing something very similar in a lost and found post. That one person happens to be a friend of Pam. They wrote, OI. Come to your conclusions on that one. I'm not even going to say what my opinion is. But I'm pretty certain you'll come to the same conclusions that a lot of people are coming to. And me, I have my opinion on it, but I'm not officially going to say anything. Can't sue me for damages if I didn't say that I am agreeing or disagreeing. I only just report the news. Anyone, have a good Monday. I don't know if I'm going to do any other videos today because, like I said, I have a lot to get done. I only just took away about half an hour of my time to do this video and to do a little follow-up and to do corrections from the first video. Like I said, as far as, like, the photos of the pets being used by VIP that were the photos that the founder took, I've been told that I'm wrong on that and that they didn't steal it, but I haven't actually seen proof that they did or did not. That'd be my flashlight. Whoops. I don't have proof on that. I did ask if they can elaborate on it a little bit, but I just couldn't get that in time from when I'm doing this video. But that's out in the open. So for now, I'm going to retract that statement anyway. So I'm just going to say officially that they may not have stolen the photos, but I don't know. Oh, and VIP, if you want to pick on me about my face, my beautiful radio face, why don't you pick on me on my tics that I have in my my muscles on my face? That'd be a better one to make fun of. Hey, make fun of that. Have a good one. Have a good rest of your day, everyone.